Okay, another lateral neck in a child with fever and respiratory distress, difficulty moving the neck. There's pain and holding the neck in a funny position. Now here we also have prevertebral soft tissue widening, but that's not from expiration or neck flexion. Okay, that's massively widened. And because younger children have lymph nodes in the retropharyngeal space that sometimes get infected, a bacterial infection of the retropharyngeal space, because the nodes are infected, is called a retropharyngeal abscess. It's not uncommon. The most common clinical presentation is fever and neck symptoms. So tuck that one away somewhere. It's uncommon for them to have respiratory distress. This is an ultrasound, which is infrequently used for retropharyngeal abscesses, but increasingly done at CHOP because we're trying to avoid CT level radiation to the thyroid of young children. Thyroid tissue is very radiosensitive. So there's an abscess there, but we got a CT scan in this case, and you can see there's an abscess in the retropharyngeal space. It's causing the airway to buckle a little bit to the right. Remember, buckling of the airway or movement of the airway to the right can occur from a mass lesion. It can also occur from expiration. The trachea buckles to the right. And this is just another CT reconstructive view, and you can see there's a big fluid collection. So we've looked at patients with retropharyngeal abscesses at CHOP and also reviewed the literature. And what we found is that the majority of cases of retropharyngeal abscess can be managed medically with antibiotics alone. And you can predict which kids will require more than just antibiotics alone if they're going to the ICU because they're so sick. If they have a very large abscess that doesn't respond to initial IV antibiotics. So we now will not get a CT scan initially in the emergency department, but rather admit them and treat them with IV antibiotics, and only get the scan if they're in a high risk group, meaning less than 15 months or not responding well to IV antibiotics. Because what we were finding is we would scan them in the ER, and then they'd get admitted on IV antibiotics anyway. And then a few days later, the subset of those patients who didn't respond to the IV antibiotics would get another CT scan. We were delivering two doses of radiation in patients, many of whom could have gotten by with no radiation, no CT level radiation at all. So that's our management of possible retropharyngeal abscess. After the age of 5 or 6, they really don't occur. It's interesting because peritonsillar abscesses almost never occur in the younger child. That's an older child phenomenon and is not associated with widening of the prevertebral soft tissues.